What are you doing to minimize all the robberies and violence happening in Dickeytown and around that area?
We've been aggressive in talking to our Minneapolis City colleagues about the need for enhanced police presence in the second precinct. I went on a ride around with the police Friday night and Saturday morning so that I understood personally more of the challenges that that they were facing. We're continuing to invest in video surveillance monitoring cameras, so we have about 1,700 of them on campus already. And we're trying to send messages about students and staff being safe and looking out for each other, walking in groups, things that common sense things that we think will contribute to public safety.
So at a large research university like the University of Minnesota, it seems like a lot of the resources and importance and attention goes to science and research and business programs. So what are you doing to ensure that the liberal arts programs receive equal amount of resources and attention?
Yeah. College funding is sorted out in an overall budget process for the university within the framework that we have. But the role of research in the College of Liberal Arts is incredibly important. We need to know how people interact with each other, how they reason, how they come to know things and their different ways of knowing. We need to understand our history, and we need to maintain and strengthen the culture that makes our civilization a great civilization. So all of those and more are at the heart of the research and creative mission in the College of Liberal Arts, and it is absolutely necessary for our society.
I'm a student in CBS, and I'm curious, what are your thoughts on the advantages of the CBS-CFANS merger?
And both CBS and CFANS have important, distinct, and different undergraduate cultures and experiences. And we want to be respectful of that. So any combined college would need to have an undergraduate program that's as good or better than the two that exist now in CFANS and CBS. So we're very mindful of that experience.
So I know some comparisons have been done comparing our university honors programs to other honors programs throughout the nation. And I was wondering if there's any, and I know there's a lot of restructuring going on, I was wondering if there's any plan to contribute more financially to the program to help in its redevelopment.
Well, again, the honors program will be allocated funding as part of the overall budget structure for the university, and different universities fund those programs in different ways. So in some institutions, funding for honors programs is included as a normal part of a college budget, mm-hmm. and in others it's called out separately. So as is true in many areas of higher education, it's very difficult to compare from institution to institution. But we value the honors program. We think it is a great opportunity for students in it. It's a magnet for highly qualified students to come to the University of Minnesota, and I want it to grow and thrive. But again, the budget structures are made within the larger university context.